Okay, Joe, this is my 22 Mark II target pistol. I made this rigging. This used to be a holster shoulder rigging also, but I took this this holster. Uncle Mike's here is for a revolver for a Smith & Wesson 41 Magnum, but I adapted it, and it works really good. You notice how the barrel protrudes through. I just cut the bottom of the holster out and put a hog ring right here, and that works really good for the target pistol. And this is on a utility belt. This is what a this is actually good rigging for my target pistol. I'll show you this rigging on. Watch me. This is my good boy Gavin. He's gonna film Daddy making this video. Show him your baby face. Come on. Show him your face.
Hi.
Okay. This sits on a utility belt. This sits really nice. I really like this. You know, they can just draw the gun right out. This works super good. And it's relatively quiet. So I'm pretty happy with this rig here. This isn't that heavy of a pistol. It's a 10-inch barrel, super accurate gun. But on the other hand, this rigging, I just wanted to show you that rigging because it might come into play here. Now this is the shoulder rigging for the Thompson Center Contender. This used to sit underneath here, but you couldn't sit down, you couldn't move, you couldn't do anything. So, of course the furnace has got to run, but anyway, you can still hear me, it's a private video. I took all the shoulder rigging off in this, show this part here. I took all the shoulder rigging off and just combined the straps. So the gun now sits like this. I kind of want something that the gun protrudes through the bottom of the holster like this does. See, this is a full length, this is a gaudy mess to try to hold on to. And I don't know if you can hear it or not, I'm going to come up close, but to look, if you had to have a deer, you know, look at the noise this thing makes. I mean, pulling that all the way out of there, just, it's way too noisy. I wanna let her know what you can come up with, but you know, as far as holding it, see, point it to me. As far as holding it, I mean, this fits really nice, you know, and it lays nice. You mentioned just about above the hip. So if we had a holster similar to this, but you can see how this actually is laying on the wrong side. This would be out here and this would be underneath this flap here. I don't know. It seems so it would be on the other side, but I don't know, you're the man. But this hangs nice. Then you could walk a long ways with this and there's no strain. And I don't know if your holster that you make was only about this long and maybe had a rawhide type of tie. I don't know if you could tie it around your leg. May not even need anything. Maybe have a hole there in case I wanted to tie it to my leg or something to keep it from flopping. But basically, you know, you can walk really good with it, and it's comfortable draw position. You know, but it's just noisy. I don't care for it there. But this is what I made out of my old shoulder rig. So if this helps you, at all. I'll take some close-ups of this rig right here. Seems like it, I don't know, should be the other way, but that's, you probably want it you can pause that and see how that was laying, but this gun actually fits in here. I don't know how it would be to carry. I'll show you that. I'll let the, give it back to the boy. See how that fits in there? Seems like the... That's kind of what I'm looking for in the leather holster. Might want to come up slightly more over the trigger guard, the leather one, but you wouldn't want it to go past the sight. But, you know, this seems like a good stop, the sight, I don't know. And it by not having to go over the sight, it seems like you can reduce the amount of leather and the size of the holster by a big way. Let me put this rigging on right here. And I'll give it back to the boy here. This is a much heavier gun. I don't know how this would be over a period of time carrying on a belt. But it comes out nice. That was a shoulder slung rig taking the weight off. I don't know. It may be fine in a belt holster. It doesn't seem that heavy. I don't know how it would be to walk with all day. I don't know, this kind of lays good. Both of them lay good, but I don't know. That's the two rigs, man. Maybe the utility belt's the way to go. But it seems like taking the shoulder slung rig, seems like it takes all the weight off your belt over a period, longer period of time. It would be more comfortable with a chest slung rig, but this does feel pretty good. Whatever you can come up with, dude, I'll be happy with, for sure. Appreciate it. And a couple more close-ups of this, I'll tune in here. This is the belt rig. It's like a utility belt that you buy. It's pretty comfortable, that belt, actually. I don't know which, if we would just do it out of the leather, the size of the bullets, I don't know. But this is the shoulder slung rig that I came up with out of the old shoulder rig. We just put the two straps together and took the cross piece off. But I definitely don't want a full length holster. This is just way too gaudy. I want the protruding barrel protruding through the holster. A lot less material, a lot less noise, a lot less everything. Okay, dude. Could be down here playing one of them at Captain John's Bar. Over and out, bud. Thank you.